Denise Hudson and City Council members, thank you first of all for giving me the opportunity to speak today. I would like to urge you to pass this ordinance. The main reason for my strong feelings about this is that I have two dogs that were rescued from Amish puppy mills. And Councilman Pike, they are both purebreds, Gettler and Charles Spaniels. The places that they came from are horrific, and they will have lifelong consequences because of that. After adopting them, I made it my goal to find out as much as I could about puppy mills and help educate other people about them. I'm a retired teacher, so that just kind of comes naturally to me. And what I've learned about the people who farm puppies has saddened and angered me. I know that some puppy mills are better than others, but that is like saying that some forms of cancer are better than others. We would like them all to go away. The problem with puppy mills is that dogs should never be factory farmed for someone's profit. The only reason these dogs are bred is for money. Little, if any, care is given to the selective breeding or to the adult dogs whose sole purpose is to make puppies. I'm sure you've heard enough about the conditions in puppy mills, and the fact is that even if it is a better puppy mill, it is still unethical. There are many ethical breeders in Northwest Ohio, and I can assure you that none of them would sell their dog to a broker or a puppy store because they care about their dogs and care about where they go. If you ask a pet store salesperson if puppies come from a puppy mill, they'll tell you that they only use hand-selected breeders. And they may tell you that the store's owner personally visits the breeders. And they'll tell you they only buy from USDA inspected breeders. But what they won't tell you is what it means to be a breeder with those credentials, or about the cruelty inherent in the production of pet store puppies. I looked at a puppy in the family puppy store. It was a mixed breed dog. As a matter of fact, all the puppies when I was in the store were mixed breeds. This dog had a price tag of $1,650. I asked to see a shop record or a health certificate, and I was refused because I was told it couldn't be found. I was shown a breeder's name. Later when I got home, I looked up that breeder, and I found a USDA inspection on September 5th, 2012, showed three violations, and that another inspection on August 27th, 2013, was unable to be done because no one was available. I've learned that this is a common ploy used to avoid inspections, having no one present when the inspection is to take place. The people of Northwest Ohio do not need to be duped into thinking that they're buying quality puppies that have been carefully bred just because someone says they are. I hope you will keep Toledo a truly humane city by passing this ordinance